All right, your boy Lucius, he owes you a little preamble. This is recorded after the Lucius cast, Drive cast, that you're going to hear following. Because I realized on my last little rant, I talked about like Rob Willis, and I didn't show any examples, man. Dude, this guy's got some examples, man. Let your jaw drop, all right? What a guy. Great artist, and like I said, if you want to laugh about my wanting to be considered in the same league as this guy, by all means do it. I don't think I could do Rob Willis better than Rob Willis. His cross-hatching is, how the hell do you describe it? I'm telling you, it's like, you know the John Henry Irons story, right? John Henry Irons versus the machine. Rob Willis is John Henry Irons. If there was a machine that could cross-hatch perfectly, Rob Willis would be the man you put in to challenge the machine, all right? And he would beat it. He would beat it, and he'd live to tell the tale and, like, scribe and be of legend forever after. He didn't have to die to do it. What a beast, a beast. I mean, and, normally, I mean, listen, I gave my art advice, and Rob does, like, really tight pencils and really tight pen work. I'm telling you, I cannot name anybody else who does it on his level, and that's why nobody ignores him. I see the guys he engages with, who would normally, under like all of his the people he has mingled with, would have just passed them up. They notice him. He's that good. I want to be that good. All right. I'm not gonna be Rob Willis, but I want to be considered on that level. At any rate, I'm gonna show his work. I'm gonna show off the Vampirella piece that I finished up, which I'm sure many of you have already seen. But I'm going to put it in there. What I'm working on right now. Today, I'll be working on a Jack Show piece. But by the time this uploads, I imagine I already have it done. I already have the rough sketched out. I'll throw it in there, too, for you to all look at. Just to see, you know, where Lucius starts and where it all ends. At any rate, that's where I'm going to leave it at. I'm going to let the rest of my free-thinking thoughts from my brain to my mouth to the recording flow from here on out. Take care, and I'll catch you on the flip side. Back again, another Lucius cast here. Oh man, I am super late for work. I had to put air in my tire. I want to keep this one kind of light, kind of off of the usual stuff, you know? I'm going to put up a video I recorded before I went into work of this, I'm going to call her Mama Fox. Been coming around last year, I believe it's same Fox. Had some pups too, and it was cute watching them. Kind of frolic around, and if they ever come up this time, I'll try to capture that and put it up for you guys. But how are y'all doing? How's your week going? Do you know what day it is? It's Thursday for me, for the world actually, or at least part of it that's in my time zone stretch. Man, oh man, what is going on in the world? I just saw something about Vince McMahon being the, economy recoverer guy for the government. What a world we live in, you know? I don't care what side you roll down. There are times, like, I just run through my head. Donald Trump is our president. Donald Trump is the president of the United States. That was a completely ridiculous notion to consider, I think 10 years ago, hell, even, I mean, how long has he been in office? Even like 6-5 years ago, before the campaign rolled out, like, it just seemed like, get out of here. Get out of here. I don't think anybody would have taken that bet. Well, except the people who are just like, oh, 10,000 to 1 odds, I'll take that. But, wow. What a world. The guy I used to watch as a kid as the ring announcer on the WWF programs is now the guy who's gonna save America. What a world, man. What a world. You know, in my mind, all you can do is laugh, and I mean, who knows? It might work out. You know, these guys have made fortunes, lost them, made them back again, so he might be the guy. He wouldn't want some destitute somebody who never even, like, had more than $1,000 at any one time to do it for you, would you? Don't think so. I got my stimulus check. Oh, man. And then I'm doing, like, pipe dreaming. Now, you guys know what I do. You know what my gig is. And I'm telling you, for about, Jesus, 15 years since I first knew that draw on tablets existed, I've wanted a Wacom Cintiq. I've wanted it for so long, guys. I don't know, it's pushing me towards it a little bit. However, these things don't come cheap. They don't come cheap. Even the, like, refurbished or somebody just reselling one that's just a couple years old, whew, it don't come cheap. But I'd love to have one. I think I'm gonna think on it, though. I'm gonna marinate on it. I'm not just gonna pull the trigger. But that was nice, man. I just looked at my account statement. Shebang. Right there at the top. 1200 in green. Man, I'm gonna be doing like shopper porn in my head at work today, man. You know, like, just like, oh yeah, I'd like that. What I really need to do, though, is get a good mic. So I think that will be number one on the list. No brainer. I don't know, you guys got any suggestions? I'm gonna try to do some searches and stuff. I think there's like the easy go-to, was it Blue Yeti? It's kind of the one I've heard over and over again, but then there's people like, nah, you don't want that. You want this. Or, you know, for half that price, this one will do just as well. And I'm not an audiophile. I know there's these people, just like in video games. So, and frame rate, the traditional, like, film standard was 24 frames per second. It's like, oh, that's all you need to really give the illusion of motion to images. 24 frames every second. You'll trick yourself into believing that it's happening or whatever. You will see the difference, though, as you go up in frame rate on how the thing looks. I think the industry standard on, or what used to be it, on like any CG 3D stuff was 30 frames a second. It takes a lot of, there's entire farms of computers that render every 3D element in like a movie. So it really matters how much you do of that. For video games, the gold standard for a while was 60 frames per second, but I think the max they do, or they'll run at, is 120 frames per second. And that kind of matters if you like have a game where like you're doing sharp spins, you know, like you're going 360 degrees or less, you know, every other second. It actually matters how your frame rate is, so it doesn't stutter. You know where you're at in terms of your perspective. But shit, Where was I going with that? I forgot my train of thought on all that shit. In terms of like audiophile, like, so I know about visuals, because that's kind of where I've steeped myself for years, you know, although I kind of let that all rot for years. But for audio, I can't tell a difference on like some megahertz things, but I'm like, if I didn't hear a better version before I heard the crappy version, it wouldn't bother me. Whereas some people pick up on it right away. I'm not that guy. So I don't know how many of you, like, this what you're hearing right now is kind of like nails on a chalkboard experience. I'm sorry if it is, you know, but I'm looking at bumping up just the whole level of everything. Now, if I do these, what I've been calling a drive cast, really only thing I'm gonna have at hand is my phone. I think I elevated things by holding it in my hand, at least. There's no rattling as it sits in a shelf. Driving conditions might hinder that, but for my standard work commute, which is all I do this for, it'll suffice. That's really cool. And who else has gotten it? What else are you thinking about buying, man? Are you looking at a flat screen? Or are you just going to put that thing in the bank? That would be the prudent thing to do. I just saw something flash up as like a notification saying that like 5 million more people have applied for unemployment. Holy shit. Did you hear that? That is the economy. That is the government banks buckling at the knees. Jesus. I think there's going to be a rude awakening. A lot of people aren't thinking about. They're all worried about getting sick. Meemaw getting sick and not thinking about whether or not they're even going to have a job or an industry to have a job in down the road. We're all familiar with a certain industry tanking pretty much out of the gate. This goes on and on. I mean, there's no influx of cash, and you only have expenses, and maybe people figure out that they don't really need your services or your product. Even when the markets are kind of open again, people go back to their jobs at large. They're not spending their money on you. They're thinking, Jesus, what if this happens next year? What if this becomes the standard conduct for the next 5 years before we finally come to our senses and realize, this was a disproportionate response to what it was. Silver lining, you know, I think I've covered it. You know, we just got caught with our pants down by something that really wasn't all that bad. You know, I'm sure people are devastated by it. We've lost more people than we would have. But listen, no one gets out alive. I feel like every person with a pretty healthy mental state at some point makes that contract in their mind that, yeah, I'm gonna check out one day. I'd love for it to be on my terms. I'd love to be it at a time where I've done everything I've wanted to do. I've seen XYZ. We're not even talking bucket list. We're talking about just what you always envision for your life list. Not the things like, oh, I want to do it before I die. No, these are things that you had to do, that you had to see happen, or you feel incomplete as a person or something. I'm hoping that, you know, everyone has something to do when it does come back, when the switches are back on for everybody, when everyone is considered non-essential, essential. Hopefully that happens. $1,200 ain't gonna do it, plus whatever you got for maybe your kids. But hopefully things turn up, and hopefully something like this happens again. We have a little better response to it all, and maybe, you know, we stop being such gross people in general. I mean, have you ever been in a store or in public, and there's that person who like is like hacking up, like, you know, like the grossest sound somebody could produce to like spit out the mucus in their throat? Imagine that going on minutes on end. You're like on the other side of the store and you hear that crap going on. Jeez, dude, you gonna let me in? It's a cop too. Imagine that going on, and then you, I'm a little distracted now, there's a cop behind me, I was clearly still am speeding, but so is everyone else, but you don't want to be that guy. Oh man, there's a speed limit drop, god damn it, this is what I gotta deal with today. This is my curse. This is my burden. Man, if I get a ticket, I'm going to be so pissed. This is going to turn this whole podcast or cast around. Oh, good. He's turning off. Yeah, I'm completely flummoxed right now. you got part of my ride right there. Yeah, I think that's good enough. I'm almost to work. If you're wondering, in the background what you're hearing is Augustana. I really dig their first two albums. They made a third one, which was one of those weird instances that their third album was like the self-titled album, you know, like, you had titles before, and then you're just like, okay, Augustana, we're Augustana. But they completely changed their sound. They tried to pull off something I don't think they really could. I don't know about them. I haven't really followed them since, so I don't know. But that's who's playing. There's a song called 20 Years. I really like it. Yeah, we'll just leave it there. Take care of yourselves. I'll check in with you soon. Hopefully you enjoyed this one, even though we kind of stayed out of all the usual business. And stay safe. Enjoy the weather if you have good weather. It's chilly up here. And enjoy the Mama Fox video. Peace.